This is a copyrighted work. Unauthorized copying or distribution is a crime punishable by up to 5 years in prison and a fine of $250,000.
Scholastic Audio presents Two Dogs in a Trench Coat Enter Stage Left by Julie Falatko. Read by Oliver Wyman. Chapter 1. Waldo could smell someone new in the room. He turned his head and inhaled deeply. Yes, he knew everyone's smell in the classroom, and there was definitely a new human somewhere. Waldo was doing what he always did on Tuesday afternoons, which was to sit on top of Sassy. Waldo was a small dog, and Sassy was a big dog, and every school day, Waldo rode around on top of Sassy, wearing a trench coat so they could pretend to be a student named Salty at B. Arthur Memorial Elementary School and spend quality educational time with their boy, Stewart. When they were pretending to be Salty, they did worksheets and sang songs and chased after baseballs. They drew pictures and played with math cubes. And they got to experience the wonder and majesty of school lunch. But Waldo could smell a new human in the classroom today, and it was confusing because he could not see any new humans.
"Do you smell someone new?" he whispered to Sassy.
"Someone who smells like jazz shoes and hot lights?" said Sassy. "Yes."
Ms. Toohey, their teacher, clapped once, and then twice, and then three times. That was the special signal that everyone needed to be quiet and pay attention. Sassy and Waldo thought that it would be best if Ms. Toohey did her clapping and then gave everyone a cookie, but Ms. Toohey did not agree for some reason.
"Class, we have a special guest here today to tell us about... Oh, where did he go?"
Ms. Toohey started looking around, confused.
"Is the special guest imaginary?"
asked Becky.
"My little brother has an imaginary friend, too."
"Our special guest is a real person," said Ms. Toohey.
"That's what my brother says, too," said Becky.
Ms. Toohey opened the classroom door and stuck her head into the hallway.
"Mr. Rollins? I wonder where he went."
She came back into the classroom and looked helplessly at the students. A man in a black turtleneck and black pants stood up slowly from behind Ms. Toohey's desk.
"Oh, there you are," said Ms. Toohey.
"I was acting," said the man, "as your chair."
"Oh, the new smell is a human who is also a chair," said Waldo.
"He's not a chair," said Charlie. "He's the second grade teacher. I saw him once when I was on composting duty and was gathering the second grade banana peels."
"Children," said the man, turning toward the class, "I am the second grade teacher and also the drama teacher. My name is Mr. Rollins. I will teach you all to be actors."
Waldo raised his hand.
"What is an actor?"
"An actor," said Mr. Rollins, "is someone who pretends to be something else on stage in a play."
"I thought that was a liar," said Waldo.
"No, they're different," said Mr. Rollins.
"How?"
asked Waldo.
"Because everyone knows the actor is pretending, and still, sometimes the actor does such a good job that the audience forgets for a bit. Like how I did such a good job acting as Ms. Toohey's chair earlier that no one noticed. When you don't know someone is pretending, that's a liar. Or a grifter. It's something very different."
"Once I saw a giant hot dog," said Waldo, but it was actually a human on Halloween. Was that person an actor, a liar, a grifter, or delicious?
Said Mr. Rollins.
Are we going to watch you in a play?
Asked Stewart.
Even better, said Mr. Rollins. You're going to be in a play.
The class buzzed with excitement.
Oh, hooray, said Waldo. I love to play.
You've been in a play before?
Asked Susan.
Playtime, yes, said Waldo. It's my favorite.
But they're talking about being in a play, said Stewart, on a stage.
There are many stages of play, said Waldo. Before play, toy gathering, running in circles, napping.
No, like actors do, said Susan, in a play.
I don't like to play with liars, said Waldo.
Ms. Toohey tacked a sign-up sheet to the bulletin board.
If you're interested in being in the play, you can sign up to audition here, said Ms. Toohey.
I am going to sign up for play,
said Waldo, digging around in his desk for his favorite crayon.
That's fun.
Mr. Rollins started handing out a stack of booklets.
You should choose a monologue from this book for your audition piece, he said. Choose something that gives you an opportunity to show off your range and depth.
Range? Like how far I can run when I'm playing? Said Waldo. Depth? Like how deep I can dig a hole?
Range and depth as an actor, said Mr. Rollins.
When I play, said Waldo.
In a play, said Mr. Rollins.
Salty and Stewart's friend Bax grabbed one of the booklets.
I hope there's something in here that'll really show off how awesome I am. I wonder if there's a speech that an action hero might give while he's hanging off the top floor of a skyscraper and about to jump onto a helicopter that's chasing him.
I just want to pick a short one that'll be easy to memorize, said Stewart.
You are going to be an actor?
Asked Waldo nervously.
I don't want Stewart to be a liar, whispered Sassy.
The dogs knew that Stewart liked to play, but they had never known he wanted to be in a play, or pretend to be a chair, or lie about being somebody else. Stewart was a good boy. He would never lie. The class crowded around the sign-up sheet. Everyone wanted to audition.
School is so many surprises, whispered Sassy. We get to sign up for special playtime.
Waldo wrote Salty in big letters on the sign-up sheet.
I am going to do the best at this new playtime, said Waldo, and pretending to be a chair, if that's part of the playing.
Don't forget that I am literally your chair all day long, said Sassy.
Chapter 2. That night, Stewart set out to choose his monologue. There was one about being or not being, a few that were full of thee and thou, and one about whether or not you could handle the truth.
This is going to be great, said Stewart,
flipping through the pages of the book.
I wonder what part I'll get. It's going to be so fun to be in a play.
It is fun to play, said Waldo.
Stewart had a feeling the dogs might not be getting it.
Well, it's not really playing. It's more like, we love to play peanut butter payback, said Sassy. Wait, what is that? Asked Stewart.
It is peanut butter payback, said Waldo. You know.
I really don't, said Stewart.
We pretend we live in a world where peanut butter is the money, said Waldo.
And all payments are in peanut butter, said Sassy.
And we need to pay someone back, said Waldo. because we borrowed money.
Peanut butter money, said Sassy. So then we use our special skills to open the cabinet. What? Said Stewart.
And blah, 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 we take the peanut butter. Never mind, it doesn't matter, said Waldo. You were saying something about this new playtime we're all going to do at school?
Yeah, said Stewart. The play will be the whole class up on a stage pretending to be other people with a beginning, a middle, and an end. It's kind of like how you pretend to be salty every day.
We don't pretend to be salty, said Waldo. We are salty.
I want to play, said Sassy, on a stage with everyone. If you want to be in the play, you have to try out for it, said Stewart. I'm going to pick one of the speeches from this book. You should choose one also. Then we'll perform the speeches for Mr. Rollins.
Sassy and Waldo read through the audition booklet, finally deciding on a passionate monologue about the importance of properly baked sponge cake. Stewart chose a short speech where he was supposed to be the tortoise from the fable about the tortoise and the hare.
I am the winner, said Stewart, glancing at the booklet between every word. Why are you talking so slowly? Asked Sassy. I am having trouble remembering the words, said Stewart. Is remembering the words important? Asked Sassy.
You should just read the lines, said Waldo. I know you can read. I see you do it every day at school, and even at night when you're in bed and Sassy and I are turning in circles to stamp down the imaginary grass in our beds like we are wild dogs.
You know how you pretend to be wild dogs sometimes, said Stewart. Being in a play is kind of like that. But we are wild dogs, said Sassy. If you were wild dogs, you wouldn't refuse to go outside when it's raining, said Stewart.
You are wrong, said Waldo. If wild dogs knew how dry and warm it was inside, they'd stay in when it's raining too. But okay, we are wild dogs on the inside.
Inside of the house, said Sassy.
Inside of the house and inside of ourselves, said Waldo. We think like wild dogs, so then we become wild dogs.
That's pretty much what acting is, said Stewart. Doing that and then memorizing your character's lines.
Both dogs lay down on the rug for a minute. They had to think. This was the first time Stewart had needed to memorize lines. Sometimes in class, they would read parts of a book out loud or read the stories they wrote, but they never had to memorize them.
You are the best boy, both as regular Stewart and wild Stewart, said Waldo, so I'm sure you'll be able to remember your lines no problem.
Maybe if I practice more. I'm going to try to do the speech. Tell me if I forget a line.
Sassy and Waldo helped Stewart work on his lines. It didn't go very well. Stewart was having trouble remembering more than 3 words at a time. The dogs were as enthusiastic as they could be. But if one of the requirements for being in a play was to remember your speech, things were looking grim.
I will treat that bunny, said Stewart. Wait, is that it? So close, said Sassy. It's supposed to be, I will beat the bunny.
I have an idea, said Waldo. We will do this the same way we trained you to give us treats. Every time you say the words in the speech right, you get a Mr. Barksy Crispy Chewy Sausage Snack.
I'm not sure that will work. And also, That was me training you to...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.